Do you want to break down a crazy game? Let's break down a crazy game. Let's do this now. Hey coach, Coach Mackey here and welcome to my channel. Let me introduce you to the world of football. That's right, baby. That's what this channel is all about. Offense, defense, special teams. We got live interviews with people like Kurt Warner, Noel Mazzoni, Hal Mummy, Jake Plummer, JT O'Sullivan, everything like that. So if this is something interesting and you want to learn more, click that subscribe button, click that bell notification to know when I go live and when I post videos, and let's get into it. I love Mike Leach. I can't wait to see what he does at Mississippi State. And what we're doing is we're breaking down a crazy, crazy game from last year, 2019. Washington State versus the man, the myth, the legend, Chip Kelly. What did Washington State do to get 63 points? What did Chip Kelly do to combat that, if anything? It was a crazy game. Let's get into every single touchdown Washington State had. And boy, they had a ton. Let's get into it. What you're going to see here is one of Coach Leach's favorite plays in the red zone. They just started doing this about 2018, 2017-ish. It's a four-man snag. He is going to motion his man out. You have got the corner. You have got first snag, second snag. And this is a very well-designed play because it picks on somebody. Okay? They're going to play the game right here. Off of this man. They're going to play the snag game off of that man right there. So you put him in motion. Now what's going to happen? Well, you got him outflanked, right? This man is going to take the running back, which is what he was going to throw it to. He is in the colored area way back here. So now you've got two men on one defender. This defender cannot be right. He chooses wrong. Touchdown. Really simple. Next touchdown. Four verts, we're setting the formation to the boundary to get this one-on-one. We've got on the numbers, going to the hash, a check down, and you will see this a lot this game in different formations. And then he has got his foot fire, getting vertical, running a simple pat and go that they run every single day at practice. And then here we go. Look, he's going to do this. Now here's what I like. You notice how his eyes are on this direction. Why? Because he wants to influence this man. He wants to get this safety, free safety, middle of the field player over on that side to open up all of this space from the hash to the sideline. That's what happens. And then he just comes and just throws it up there. A nice, perfect catch. Look how he caught it over his shoulder like that. I promise you, they do this every single day in pat and go. We're going to watch it from the end zone copy. Watch what I like also. Throws hand signals down so everyone knows what to do. Watch his footwork. You can't get any better than this. Boom. He's looking this way just real quick. Influence this guy just a little bit to move this way. Plant sets his feet. Throws a nice moon ball over the shoulder. Touchdown. Just like they do in practice every single day. Got a little bit of screen action right here, which I love. You're going to see what I like. Watch this guy. They pass set. He gives him a hard, violent, hey, get out of here. And then they're releasing right here. We got a play fake. And then we just got the screen up top, which is so nice. We're going to number two. Why are we going to number two? Well, he's got the man furthest off of him. So, actually, he's going here, here. He's going to come up, get underneath, and then get in the alley and back out. You couldn't draw it up any better. There's the big guys right here. He needs to seal, which he does. Look, I want you to see it again. He's coming to block this man. He realizes the big man's coming, so he goes back. And that's how you get in and then get out. You've got to teach your wide receivers that concept. When you get a screen, hey, get in, get underneath the blocks, get right back out. Watch this violent, violent shove right here by this tackle. Oh, I love that. Can't get any better than that. Get in, get out, get to the pylon, and score. Earlier in the game, you saw them score on a four-man snag, a four-man overload. So UCLA is cognizant of that. What they do is they go straight up man, 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 which leaves everybody else is going to be blitzing or show blitzing. Look at all this grass right back here. This is too simple. Way too simple. What they're going to do is they're going to foot fire and run a slant right there. Look how he sets his man up, though. Which is amazing. All right, you see how he's pounding the drums? See how it's about pound, 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 pound. Sets him outside. Look, he's already outside. already outside. He's at a position right here, which opens up this slant. He already knows where it's going. He is throwing the ball before he even makes the break. That's something you need to teach your quarterback. Hey, listen, you've got to trust that the wide receiver is going to be there. Throw the ball before he makes the break. There it is. Really simple. Boom. All right, let's watch it from the back, from the end zone copy. Can't do any better. Look at this. They're half sliding to the left. So one there, there. Got man on, man on. He is the only one that can run free. So the running back comes up, steps up, meets him in the hole. Great pass protection. But I mean, look at that. Gets low. Helmet below his chin. Gets it. You can see right now all of that grass area. An easy pitch and catch that I promise you they do that every single day in practice on settle up, on pat and go, all of that stuff. Unbelievable. And it's just too easy. One-on-one back shoulder throw. When you work on this every single day, it becomes second nature. It is such an easy concept to get good at. Look, we have there's no help over top. They're man to man again. He has got the running back right here. So take your best matchup. Find whichever corner is the weakest. You're going to attack. That's what Coach Leach did right there. Look at him. Throw it at the back of his helmet, which the only thing he can make is either the wide receiver makes it or it's out of bounds. That's great control with the footwork and the body on the wide receiver. You can only do that if you practice it every day. Here's the end zone copy. Just one step and throw it. The only person, notice how he throws it right at his helmet, eyes on it. Look, he is noosing the ball like they do in settle up and noose. He makes sure his eyes are on it, and then he is putting his foot down right there. He's looking down, putting it down, boom. Such a nice catch. This play right here is amazing. It's something new that Coach Leach is doing. I don't know what it's called or anything like that, but let me draw it up for you. Vert, you are going to act like you're meshing, but after you mesh, you run up the seam. For this guy, he is going to run a post. This man is going to run all the way to the numbers, run up the numbers like it's a vert. It looks like four verts. It really gives the defense a difficult time. He doesn't know what he's doing. Look at this. Boom. Now it's a foot race. He's screwed. Look at all this grass back here. Touchdown. I mean, I would not call this in a high school game unless you have unbelievable blocking, but it is just incredible. It really messes with the defense, especially if you run a lot of mesh. You think, okay, mesh. Oh, goodness, what are they going to do? Look at from the end zone copy right here. Way to pick up. So, again, you've got the half slide right here, right here, right here. Man on, man on. He is not accounted for. For the line, so he's going to step up right there. Great protection. Watch the quarterback doesn't get nervous. He sees that man blitz in the A gap, doesn't get nervous, sits in there, waits for a second, and then throws a strike. He knows it's a touchdown before he even throws it by the way he jumps. Unbelievable play. This is like stealing candy from a baby. You've got one-on-one out here. Again, he's got inside leverage. So what they're going to do is just going to tag it with a quick out. It's so simple. You see it, take it, quick out, throw it really quick. What the aiming point is for the quarterback on the quick out is this pylon right here. So the wide receiver and the quarterback are on the same page. He takes a quick set, throws it right at the pylon. You can't defend that. So if you see that off and inside, just go ahead, tag it with the quick out, which is what they did. Boom, touchdown. Remember I said you're going to see that four verts concept that we saw at a two back from earlier again for a touchdown. You've got it right here at a two by two. We've got vert. He now is going to replace and be the sit down, which leaves one on one. We're going to, he scored before against this corner. We're going to do it again. Foot fire and release. It's so nasty. All right. Look at him. Look at him pounding. Boom, boom, boom. Step. He is leaning. He made him lean inside, which is his fatal mistake because now he can get back on top for a touchdown right there. Already did it once in the game. Coach Leach comes back, does it again because why are you not going to come back to something that scored you a touchdown the first time? Well, look, here's also something what I like. Look at the signals back here. Boom. Signals. Really simple. He's going to take his right here. He doesn't have anybody in the middle of the field, so he doesn't have to look them off, and he just throws it out there. That's something, again, that is pat and go. Settle up and noose. That's what they do every single day, so that's why he's able to catch it over his shoulder like that without turning around or anything and signaling to the DB, hey, I'm catching the ball. Turn around with me. It's like, nope, I'm going to catch it right at the last second for a touchdown. We've got the scissors concept, but really just remember this. If you have a dude at running back, sometimes the best play is just to dump it off to him and let him do what he does. Got scissors action right here. You've got the in right here, and then he is going to the flat. Nothing is open, so what do? They just dump it off to their running back and make one dude miss. Boom. Now, here's a coaching point. Here's something that if you're going to throw the ball, you've got to get great at. You've got to teach the wide receivers that when they don't have the ball, they come back and block. This is the block right here that sprung this play and made it such a huge play for them. So teach your wide receivers, once the ball is thrown, they turn around and they have to get the block. Let's see it from the back. All right, notice they're not going anything. UCLA has been playing straight up man the entire game. They decided to go zone right here, dump the ball off, and then boom, there's that block. Look, it wasn't a devastating block. It was just a boom, get in the way. Didn't even hit him. He just scared the defender enough, and then it's one-on-one. Can your guy beat their guy, which they do in this case, for a touchdown. Biggest takeaways from this game, if something works, keep going at it. Give the ball to your guys. Let them make one guy miss and then run. Don't be afraid to throw the ball over and over again. That's 9 touchdowns. Yes, they lost this game. Crazy. I know. How? Ball security. So when you make your practices, you've got to have a period where you are working on ball security. We have something called the ball security drill, which we have bags, we have cones, and we do that 5 minutes every single day, because if you're not stressing ball security, you are going to be in a world of hurt, just like Mike Leach was. If this is something you like the film breakdown, I've got 2 of them right here for you. Boom and boom and boom and boom, somewhere around here. And until next time, let's continue to master the spread, score points, and have fun.